The governor of the Reserve Bank is once again under pressure to resign this morning after apologising for predicting interest rates wouldn't rise until 2024. Today, correspondent Lara Vella has the details. Lara, Philip Lowe concedes he got it wrong.
Sort of, Carl. It's the kind of patronising apology you might get from someone who thinks that they're a little bit smarter than you. Basically saying to ordinary Australians, I'm sorry for the way that you misinterpreted what I said and that you didn't realise there were terms and conditions attached. This is, of course, in relation, Carl, to comments made by the Reserve Bank Governor, Philip Lowe, essentially saying that interest rates would more than likely not rise until 2024 based on the health of the economy at that time. Since then, though, Carl, we now know there have been seven consecutive interest rate rises, and the forecast is for yet another one next month, adding hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars to monthly mortgage repayments. That has been absolutely crushing, Carl, from everyone from first home buyers to small businesses and renters who are feeling the knock-on effects. Here was that so-called apology from the RBA governor during a parliamentary committee.
I'm sorry that people listened to what we'd said and acted on that and now find themselves in a position they don't want to be in, but at the time, we thought it was the right thing to do, and I think looking back, we would have chosen different language. You're right, people did not hear the caveats.
So for now, Carl, the PM says that he retains confidence in the RBA governor, but there have now been renewed calls from some factions of politics, essentially asking him to step down over these comments made about interest rate hikes. In the meantime, Carl, the RBA says that it's going to reform the way that they give forward economic forecasts.
All right, Lara, thank you. Now, if you took out a mortgage expecting interest rates to remain at record lows until 2024, well, here's your sorry.
I'm sorry that people listened to what we'd said and acted on that and now find themselves in a position they don't want to be in. But at the time, we thought it was the right thing to do. And I think looking back, we would have chosen different language.
Oh, yeah. Well, joining us from Canberra is Domain's Chief of Economics, Nicola Powell. Nicola, does sorry cut it there, you reckon? Mm.
Look, I think it has been a hard time for homeowners. You know, they have seen a 2.75 percentage points increase in interest rates since May. So it's certainly damaging hip pockets for everybody's budget that has a mortgage.
Why is everyone so reluctant to say maybe he should go?
Oh, look, I think when you have a look at interest rates, you know, we've got high levels of inflation. We've got inflation at, you know, 7.3%. And he's really trying to rein in spending. I think nobody expected inflation to hit as high, and it's still rising, expecting to hit a peak by the end of this year. So, you know, it is a grim outlook. And it is hard for people that have got a mortgage and trying to balance that budget, because it's those essential items of living that is really escalating as well as trying to balance having a mortgage.
So another rate rise before the end of the year. What does that then mean for people?
So, look, there is about a 30% chance that interest rates will remain stable next week, which I think is really good news for mortgage holders out there. I think, you know, when you have a look at interest rates remaining stable, we haven't got the RBA meeting until February again next year. So that is really good news for those homeowners. But there is a 70% chance that we are likely to see those interest rates move up by 25 basis points. That's going to add about $80 a week to a $500 $500,000 home loan. And when you have a look at the cumulative increase in interest rates since May, it's going to add about $900 to a $500,000 home loan. So, you know, this is really damaging to those budgets, and, you know, homeowners are struggling to meet those mortgage repayments.
Okay, there are some reports in the paper today that SQM research is pointing at some point the next year, there being a comeback with property from 3% to 7%. That kind of defies what we're seeing thus far, but does that marry up with what you're saying?
What we're expecting actually is the market next year to bottom out. So we're expecting those interest rates to hit about a peak of about 3.85% September, October next year. And then, dare I say it, we're expecting the RBA to then start cutting interest rates. At the same time, what we're expecting with property prices, they will probably trough sometime around that same period, maybe early into the following year. But I think certainly next year is going to provide better buying opportunities out there. We're seeing stock rise. So what that means is buyers have power, they have power to negotiate, but we're likely to see that trough in price hit sometime next year.
Yikes. To break it down, we're joined by Executive Chairman of Yellow Brick Road Home Loans, Mark Boris. Mark, That apology, what did you think? Was it the right thing to do and did it cut the mustard?
Well, one, it is the right thing to do. So it's good to see the Reserve Bank Governor come and admit that he got the timing wrong, because that has had a massive effect on a lot of Australians. What does it mean? I don't think it means anything at the end of the day, except that the Reserve Bank Governor and the Reserve Bank going forward might be a little bit more circumspect about kickers and in the guts with big interest rate rises going forward. So that goes right to the very heart of what's going to happen next.
So you think this is telegraphing the next potential rate rise, that it may be smaller than the last one?
I think it'll be the same as the last one, but I think they are going to put a bit of a stopper on where they're going to go after this. I think they'll probably have another rate rise next month, and I think they're going to may even say something that we're going to stop and have a look from here on end. Just be quite responsible about it.
I just want to bring it back to this apology. So this relates to this statement that he made that there would be no more interest rate rises, or there would be no interest rate rises until 2024. So many people rushed in and bought homes based on that promise. There are families now who are crippled under the rising interest rates that are adding to their mortgages every single month as those rate rises go up. Should he keep his job? That was a really strong mistake, a really bad mistake to make. He's earning just under $1 million a year in this gig.
Well, his job comes up for renewal in September in 2024, which
does he deserve to keep it?
Well, it's more than likely, in my opinion, they will get rid of him. And I'm not saying he deserves it or otherwise, but I think that this will be a political out and allow everybody to sort of put this to rest. Sometimes you have to take the scalp of the boss. And I think, but by the way, it's not just him. He doesn't make the decisions. He gets recommendations from 500 Reserve Bank economists who put it to a board of which he's the head. So there's a lot of people whose scalps could be at risk here too. So I think you'll find some of the other Reserve Bank Reserve Bank board members might also get the boot.
However, that board and those people that are dealing with these are issues that affect Australians. You know, the hip pocket of regular Aussies that aren't earning six figures or like these board members are. So this really puts the whole thing into focus, that a lot of people could lose their heads. And it's out of touch with what the Australian people need right now.
I think it's totally out of touch, and I think it's also out of touch for governments to expect the Reserve Bank governor to know how to deal with media. Like, there's no media training. What I'd like to know, who was it advising him to say these sorts of things? Who it was it actually gave him the media training as to how to say which language and words to use, how to phrase this sort of stuff, what's the timing of it? In my opinion, people like him should not be talking to the media. They should be making the decisions like the Australian Bureau of Statistics and just telling it as it is, and that's it.
End of story. Put out a press release.
They're pulling the levers on our nation's economy. They're sending the signals to everyone in our country about what is ahead and how they should manage their own personal finances. How are we at a point where they can't convey the messaging clearly to the public?
Well, that's a very good point. And if the regulator was sitting here looking at me saying to people, well, this is what you should be doing right now, and if something went around the other way, people listening to this show could come and sue me and the regulator would be all over me. Who's all over the Reserve Bank Governor? Who's all over the government, all the government instrumentalities? And I think this is a great time to have a review of the Reserve Bank Board, which is actually what's happening right now. There's a review going on. And what is the Reserve Bank Board and the Governor, what is their actual role? Is it just to be statistical and execute on policy, or is it to address the public?
But we know, I mean, look, Biden has been talking about inflation the last 8 to 10 months as well. We know that this has been, around the world, this has been a problem. However, the wording and words matters. Would it have been better to slow down how the interest rate rises are going and build consumer confidence over these last 6 months?
I don't think so. I think the Reserve Bank Governor should say
nothing. They had no choice.
No, he should say nothing.
Right.
Just put out the statement and leave it as is. Mm. Because the problem is people like me, markets, people operating markets, media, we all sit there interpreting every single word.
That's right.
And we don't know how to interpret because we don't know the context of what he's saying. Because he already said yesterday, oh, yeah, but people didn't read the fine print that I was saying based on circumstances at the moment. Well, circumstances at the moment, from my point of view, was that they were pretty bad because he was telling me how bad they were. And therefore, interest rates aren't going to go up. The reason interest rates aren't going to go up because they're pretty bad. So I interpreted that way. So everybody interpreted that way. All of us got it wrong, according to him now. I'd like to actually know, did he really believe when he said interest rates won't be going up in 2024, that there may be a change in circumstances?
Well, you think when you heard that? I mean, you have insight into the market, into the industry, into the business, into the nation's finances. When he said that, did you think, that doesn't sound right to me?
I didn't think that, but I thought that's a pretty bold statement that I haven't heard Reserve Bank governors say in these environments. He's uncertain times, tough environments. I hadn't heard someone say that as audaciously as this Reserve Bank governor said. Now, whether he was asked to say that by the government at the time, we need confidence in the marketplace. We've got an election coming up. We don't want people to think interest rates going up. Who knows? Mm. I don't know what the interactions are between government and the Reserve Bank governor. Who knows what they are? And by the way, who knows what they are now? Because what's interesting about this is the Prime Minister got out and said, I have confidence in the Reserve Bank governor, straight off the back of the Reserve Bank governor's apology yesterday. Now, whether or not that means the Prime Minister is going to, you know, endorse him for the next period or not, I don't know. But it looks, to me, the two things are very coordinated. It looks very media savvy to me.
Interesting.
A bit, maybe it's a little too late. But just quickly, the people out there, we know the market softened amazingly, that the last weekend was really bad. What's going to happen? If there are prospective homeowners out there, what should they do? What's your advice if they're going to take out a loan?
There's going to be an interest rate rise again in December. If you're looking to buy a property, I firmly believe that this down period is only going to last 9-10 months into next year. If you're trying to take out a loan now and you've got the approval and you find the property that's at the price that you now think it's worth today, as opposed to what it might be worth in the future, but today, then my advice is you should be buying the property. That's because you qualify for it, you found the joint you love, it is at a price you can afford. Mm. If it's affordable, buy it. Do not try to arbitrage the market. In other words, don't try to beat the market or pick the lowest point, etc. We've already are at a low point in the market. Now, property prices are off 15 to 20%. If you're expecting to go back down 30%, you might miss the market. Mm. So I think now's the right time to buy if you've got the approvals.
Yeah. All right. Well, for more, we're joined by Minister for Government Services and the NDIS, Bill Shorten, in the studio, and Scott Emerson from 4BC. Nice to see you both. So, Bill, say you've got like a $500,000 mortgage. You're paying an extra $800 or so a month. Do you reckon that apology cuts it?
Well, I don't think it's going to contribute an extra dollar to your mortgage, so I won't insult people who have got to pay the extra mortgage. But the governor of the Reserve Bank's independent position, so the last thing, you've got to respect the independence of the office. He said sorry.
You read that and you go, if you listened to me and sort of did what and made decisions based on what we said, well, of course a lot of people did, because you make the decisions as to what happens with interest rates.
Yeah, so I think the question in that statement is, what do we think about him? He's the governor of the Reserve Bank, it's an independent position. The politicians piling in is not going to help. If he's saying sorry, it's not going to change the amount of mortgage you're paying. Us piling in on him is not going to change the amount of mortgage you're going to pay either, so try and keep the politics out of it.
Yeah, I mean, and I've noticed that a lot of our politicians won't sort of go there. I know Scott will, though. What do you reckon of an apology with so many caveats?
Oh, come on. And Bill there saying, oh, well, I don't want to pile in on him. We saw Albo yesterday saying, I've got complete faith in this bloke. Well, who else has complete faith in this guy? He came out and said interest rates weren't going to rise until 2024. Then he says, oh, I put all these caveats on it. Well, no one heard those caveats. He didn't want anyone to hear the caveats. He wanted people to believe interest rates wouldn't go up. He got it completely wrong. The sorry does not cut it. I know there's a review into the Reserve Bank. Mm. That review should conclude at the end that he should be gone. That's just the reality for all those people who are paying massive rises in their mortgages because they took the advice of Philip Lowe.
Is there a disconnect with Canberra as to the impact of that statement and the decision that people made? Oh,
there's no disconnect for me when I know mortgage holders are doing it tough. Whether or not he apologised, ultimately it's not going to change the mortgage you're paying. Mm. The challenges in the economy are definitely much bigger than whether or not the governor of the Reserve Bank says sorry. I'm not defending the bloke and I'm not putting the boot in. We are where we are with mortgages. It's tough for people. We've got to do the best we can to help with cost of living. Mm. Mr. Lowe's apology or not, not going to change that.
Okay, so your help with cost of living, energy bills, we're told they're going to come down by $275 by Christmas?
Well, we're doing everything we can to decrease energy bills. Of course, the promises made before the election, before Putin's invaded Ukraine, that has certainly upended a lot of things. We've got 9 years of denial and delay by our predecessors. The reality is energy policy has been kicked into the long grass for nearly a decade. We're now taking out the long grass and tackling it. It'll take
some time.
Totally
get that,
but
when are people actually going to see a bit of relief with their bills?
Well, it's going to be tough for a while. There can be no doubt about that.
Okay.